हेलो स्टूडेंट्स, वी आर डिस्कसिंग ए चैप्टर कॉल्ड ह्यूमन हेल्थ एंड डिसीजेस। इन दिस चैप्टर, इन प्रीवियस क्लास वी डिस्कस्ड द ए टॉपिक कॉल्ड एज यूजफुल माइक्रोब्स इन हाउस होल्ड प्रोडक्ट्स। नाउ वी आर गोइंग टू स्टडी वन मोर एस्पेक्ट्स कॉल्ड यूजफुल माइक्रोब्स इन इंडस्ट्रियल प्रोडक्ट्स। फर्स्ट वन, बिफोर गोइंग टू दिस इंडस्ट्रियल प्रोडक्ट्स, फर्स्ट वी आर गोइंग टू नो द ए alcoholic fermentation. Okay, alcoholic fermentation means the anaerobic breakdown of glucose into ethyl alcohol and carbon dioxide by the zymase enzyme of yeast is called alcoholic fermentation. The microbes are used to produce a number of valuable products in industries. The large scale production of industrial products require a growing microbes in very large vessels called fermenters or bioreactors. Okay, when come to the first useful microbes in industrial product is fermented beverages or alcoholic beverages. What the microbes are there? Those microbes are able to produce the alcoholic beverages or fermented beverages. They perform the process called alcoholic fermentation. Alcoholic fermentation. Here the microbe is called Saccharomyces cerevisiae. Here the Saccharomyces cerevisiae is called as Brewer's yeast. This is used for the production of alcoholic beverages like wine, beer, brandy, whiskey, rum, etc. The wine and beer are obtained from without distillation process. Brandy, whiskey, rum obtained with distillation process. Based on type of raw material, we are going to produce a type of for alcoholic or fermented beverages. The whiskey, the raw material is cereals, rum, a molasses, then brandy, fruit juices, wine and brandy, fruit juices, beer, barley. So raw material barley for the beer, fruit juices for wine and brandy, cereals for whiskey, molasses for rum. This is about the alcoholic or fermented beverages. Okay, next we are move on to the a second industrial product called as a chemicals. The three chemicals like citric acid, acetic acid, butyric acid. Aspergillus niger, a fungus. Aspergillus niger, a fungus, produces the citric acid. Or the citric acid is obtained from a fungus called Aspergillus niger. Second, acetic acid is obtained from a bacteria called Acetobacter aceti. Then the butyric acid is from Clostridium butyricum, it is a bacteria. Then one more is there, lactic acid, from lactic acid bacteria. So these are the chemicals are obtained from the respective microbes. Then bioactive molecules. There are two bioactive molecules are there. One is cyclosporine A, another called as statins. Cyclosporine A is obtained from Trichoderma polysporum. The Trichoderma polysporum, it is a fungus. From this fungus, the cyclosporine A is obtained or produces. The cyclosporine A, it is a bioactive molecule used as immunosuppressant in organ transplanted patient. So here we are going to, when we are going to conduct the organ transplantation process, that means kidney transplantation or other, we are going to consider the blood group, size of the organ, shape of the organ. Apart from this one, also we are going to consider the immune system. So if any cells of immune system varies, the mismatch will be taken place. In that condition, immunosuppressant agent we are going to use it as a cyclosporine A. Next, statins. Statin, a second bioactive molecule. This statin bioactive molecule obtained by the yeast called Monascus purpureus, a fungus called Monascus purpureus. Statins used as blood cholesterol lowering agent. It means the statin able to inhibit the enzyme responsible for synthesis of cholesterol. Then enzymes. One is lipases, second proteases, third pectinases. When come to the lipases, these are the lipid digesting enzyme obtained from the fungus called Candida lipolytica. One more fungus called Geotrichum candidum. The lipases enzymes are used in detergent formulation to remove the oily stain from the laundry. Next, proteases. These are the protein digesting enzyme obtained from fungus called Mortirella ramispora, another Aspergillus species. These proteases enzymes are used in clearing the whiskey, beer, softening of bread, meat, and manufacturing of liquid glue, etc. Third, pectinases. These are pectin digesting enzyme obtained from the fungus called Bacillus fulva. The pectinases enzyme along with proteases enzyme used in clearing the bottled fruit juices. Apart from this one, the pectinases also used in rotting of fibers and preparation of green tea also. This is about the enzymes. Okay, one more enzyme is there called streptokinase enzyme. It is an enzyme obtained by the bacteria called Streptococcus. The streptokinase enzyme is also called tissue plasmogen activator. The streptokinase enzyme is commonly called as clot buster enzyme because it used for removing the blood clot from blood vessels of the myocardial infarction patients, nothing but heart attack patients. So these are the enzymes and respective microbes helpful to producers. okay. Once again, concentrate it. The alcoholic or fermented beverages. Here the responsible microbe is Saccharomyces cerevisiae, nothing but the Brewer's yeast, by a process called alcoholic fermentation. Next, Aspergillus niger, it is a fungus, produces the citric acid. Acetobacter aceti, it is a bacteria, produces the acetic acid. Clostridium botulicum produces the butyric acid. Then Trichoderma polysporum, it is a fungus, produces the cyclosporin A. Monoscus purpureus, it is a also fungus, produces the statin. Then Candida lipolytica, Geotrichum candidum, produces the lipases enzyme. Motterella ramispora, Aspergillus species, these two are fungus, produces the proteases. Then Basocalmus fulva, it is also a fungus, produces the pectinases. Then Streptococcus bacteria produces the streptokinase enzyme. So these are the respective microbes and respective industrial products. One thing we are going to concentrate, only bacteria and fungus are useful, not other things. Then when come to the functional aspects, lipases used in detergent formulation to remove the oily stains. Then proteases used in clearing the whiskey and beer. Pectinases as well as proteases, both are helpful to clearing the bottled fruit juices. Streptokinase enzyme used as a clot buster, remove the blood clots from the blood vessel, the person who undergo myocardial infarction or heart attack. Then the bioactive molecules like cyclosporin A, it is used as an immunosuppressant agent. Statin, so it is a blood cholesterol lowering agent. It inhibits the enzyme which is responsible to inhibit the synthesis of blood cholesterol level. Okay. Finally, when come to the last one, called as a antibiotics. Antibiotics defined as the chemical substances produced by certain microbes which kill or inhibit the growth of other microbes. Such chemical substances are called antibiotics. Then the word antibiotic is derived from two Greek words, that is called as anti means agent, bio means life. The antibiotic word was coined by Selman Waksman in 1942. The antibiotics are pro-life or fruitful for human beings. Then the commonly used antibiotic is penicillin. This penicillin, it is a first antibiotic discovered by a scientist called Alexander Fleming in 1928 from the fungus called Penicillium notatum. Its full potential the full potential can be given by the two other scientists are Ernst Chain and Howard Florey. Alexander Fleming firstly discovered the penicillin, a antibiotic from fungus called Penicillium notatum. The Ernst Chain and Howard Florey provide the potentialness to the penicillin. Finally, the penicillin was extensively used to treat the American wounded soldiers in the World War II, for which Alexander Fleming, Ernst Chain and Herbert Flore was awarded Nobel Prize in 1945 for this discovery. Since there more than 5,000 antibiotics are known today, only about 100 are in medicinal use. There are two types of antibiotics. One is broad spectrum, another called as a narrow spectrum. Broad spectrum means the antibiotics which kill or destroy the different group of pathogens. Different group of pathogen means either bacteria, viruses, protozoan, etc. Then the narrow spectrum antibiotics are the antibiotics which kill or destroy a specific type of pathogen. This is called as a narrow spectrum. So the best example for antibiotics are, one is bacitracin, polymyxin B, cyclomycin. These are the best example which are extracted or were obtained from the a true bacteria called Eubacteria. Then streptomycin, chloromycin, erythromycin, tetracycline, terramycin, neomycin, etc. These are the other group of antibiotics obtained from actinomycetes. Then penicillin, cephalosporin, fimagillin, clavicin, bacatin, etc. These are the antibiotics are obtained from fungus. The Alexander Fleming, accidentally discovered this penicillin antibiotic from a fungus called and a Penicillium notatum. Basically, the Alexander Fleming worked on a bacteria called Staphylococcus, but unexpectedly he discovered the penicillin, a antibiotic. Okay, this is about the industrial products. Here what happens, what the industrial products are there, whether the alcohols or enzymes or bioactive molecules or antibiotics, the production of industrial product in large scale require a large vessels for growth of microbes. Those we are called as a fermenters or bioreactors. Because the microbes require large vessel for the growth, because of for the production of large amount of industrial products. Okay, so this is about the industrial products like alcoholic beverages or fermented beverages, in that wine, beer, brandy, whiskey, rum. Wine and beer are without distillation beverages, brandy, whiskey, rum are with distillation beverages. Okay, here the Saccharomyces cerevisiae, it is a fungus, it is a yeast, are responsible for the production of fermented beverages or alcoholic beverages. So the Saccharomyces cerevisiae, a yeast which is helpful for the production of alcoholic or fermented beverages, such Saccharomyces cerevisiae is called Brewer's yeast. Okay. Next class we are move on to the next topic called as a how microbes are useful in industrial sewage water treatment process. So sewage water, nowadays it causes more amount of water pollution. Before we passes the sewage water into the any river water or any water resources, we are going to treat, we are going to reduce the a pollutant. In that, in some extent, we are going to reduce the water pollution. Next class, we are going to study what is meant by sewage water, what are the sewage water contains, how the sewage water treatment plant perform the process. In that sewage water treatment process, how the microbes are useful for the treatment process, and all those things we are going to study in next class. Thank you.